So there's around 100 million people in the United States alone suffering with chronic pain. This pain that persists for 3-6 months and really impacts their lives. And I was a clinician trying to help patients with pain. Pain was always subjective. You ask them from 0 to 10, give me a number, they're gonna say 3, 5, 7. It's very subjective, very difficult to see if something's working or not based on those numbers. So there are technologies that we can use now that can collect all this information, that's what we are working on, to help the patient in an intuitive way to add their pain and symptoms, like the Google map of their pain and how that changes across the days or even hours. And with the generation AI, summarize that, providing extra time to the clinician to actually interact with the patient when most of the work to understand what are the changes with the patient is already there for the patient and the clinician. I think one of the first patients that we used was a lady with like in her 70s or 80s. She saw that you could put the information of her pain and symptoms in the way that was, not only one number, but you know, in the right side of my head, the pain is around 7, but it's not the full head. But my arm is also painful. It's really hurting me. So if you have a treatment, all this information is available for the patient that can share that information with doctors, family, but also available to defined by artificial intelligence, for example, what's the best treatment for you based on the information that you provide.
A lot of our patients with pain have a significant delay to diagnosis. In addition, when patients come to our clinic and we ask them about their pain condition, we get only a glimpse of their history, and that can be very biased. So for us to have an app technology that our patients can easily utilize, that's very intuitive, and have them be able to tell us their story over a month or two, what other associated signs and symptoms did they have, how they responded to specific medications for them, what made it better, what made it worse from appointment to appointment, and share those reports with us. This has been very important for us.
So now, this technology that helped in the past more than 15,000 patients across the United States, including 30% outside the United States, we have now integrated, and you're working on that, in the health system so that all the stakeholders can now help the patient, including the clinicians. Most of these patients with chronic pain, they need a team to help them. It's not only the dentist, it's the neurologist, it's the psychiatrist, the psychologist, physical therapist. So we need to find a way with technology, understand of the pathophysiology, how we can together better provide treatment to those patients. So anything, any information that you provide, we cannot think about that in a silo. We need to be an interprofessional kind of treatment for those patients. What we learned with the BOLD initiative, it's how to create value for all the stakeholders, all the teams that we have, all the institutions that now we are working together to create centers, to create better education, treatment, and research across the United States. It was the fund, it was the guidance, it was the mentoring during the BOLD initiative to really optimize that idea that we had. And that's the success, that it was the outcome. It was instead of a grant from the National Institute of Health that was only for my lab and some collaborator, it was support now for different departments and different institutions to then create centers to help several people across the United States.
Watching Alex's success, both with patients and with funding agencies, that's what BOLD Challenges is all about. We meet people where they are, we empower them to do better, and with that, we try to help make the entire University of Michigan community more effective, more collaborative, and more innovative than ever before. He's the type of physician researcher that the University of Michigan is known for throughout the world. And like so many people at U of M, he has this incredible vision, and he's turned it into a great discovery that can make life better. Bold Challenges is built for innovators and dreamers just like Alex.
We really want to help each other. And if you are a Go Blue research team, you need to be bold to make a difference here in our society. There are several resources here at the University of Michigan. The Bold Initiative is a wonderful one to help researchers, labs, and create a large impact in our society.